joining us. Jax.
Yes.
We've been getting visitors. We've been getting text messages.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Thank you very much for all those who watch our show.
You know, I got a text message. It was a couple of weeks ago. This girl was saying, "Oh, your guest is so guapo."
That was, Ang dami-dami natin guwapo na guest.
It was Congressman Timmy Chepeco.
Yeah.
Diba? And then, I also got another text from Arlene Ponce. She watched the episode of Lola Buko. Mm-hmm. And she actually wants to help out.
Oh, great.
Yeah, I know. You know, it's so nice when people want to help.
That's true.
I'll read the text, yeah.
Yeah, my Tita Sexy able to give 5,000 pesos. So that would... allow them to afford to buy their cart.
Right.
And there's 2,000 extra, so that can also help them. But your friend,
Arlene Ponce, she's actually the one who makes uniforms. So it's actually good that she's giving back also. By the way, your guest last week, Lolo and Lola Vendor, I'd like to sponsor 5,000 pesos for their carretela. See how nice.
Okay, so since we already gave 5,000 for their cariton,
yes,
then they can actually buy their buko.
Yeah, so that way they don't have to get the buko and then return. They only keep so little, right?
Yes,
a certain
that's true.
Percent.
Yeah. Then now they can buy it all and then they can make more money for themselves.
See, good things happen to good people. I really believe in
mm-hmm.
that.
Thank you, Tita Sexy, and thank you, Arlene.
Thank you for our really kind viewers. Mm-hmm. I mean, right?
I know.
We're also blessed that we have viewers that have big hearts.
Yes, we are. Thank you to all of you.
So how was your week?
My week, let me see. I don't even remember. Well, I went to Region 7. But before that, I also went on a holiday with my in-laws because it was the birthday of my mother-in-law.
Oh, happy birthday.
So that was like 2 months ago. Meets, happy birthday. I love you.
Where'd you guys go?
We went to Bora.
Ah, nice.
Yeah, in a place that's actually barricaded now.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Not nice. You know, remember I invited you to the Miley Cyrus concert, but...
Yeah, just a minute. Can I thank Chris Aquino for and the whole staff of West Cove? Thank you very much for the stay there.
Oh, cool. So, nice.
So you went to...
Oh, yeah. You know how I invited you to Miley Cyrus?
Yes, I know. I couldn't make it.
Yeah, and you couldn't make it and...
How was the show?
I was, to say the least, surprised.
Because compared to Justin Bieber's concert?
Oh, Justin's was great. With Miley, I guess I was surprised because I know that the little children love her.
Yes.
Because of Hannah Montana, right?
Yes, yes, yes.
I mean, around the concert, you'd see girls dressing up like her.
Yes, yes.
And
little children and young teens.
Yeah, mm-hmm. like the tweens and the mm-hmm. and little kids.
Yes.
But she was wearing... Remember the Madonna concert, like a Virgin, when she had like a bra top on with like the Jean Paul Gaultier with the beads and
stuff.
Yes,
with like a spiral. Yeah,
and then she had
she wore that.
Yes, and then shorts with like those garter straps. And my concern was, I hope the kids don't
copy
her,
that.
You know, I mean, considering I was looking around, all the kids were like copying the way she was dancing mm-hmm. and singing and dressing up. So and also. The dancing, I know she's 18,
age.
And I know like she's probably like going through identity crisis because mm-hmm. she's like in between, you know, I want to show people that I'm sexy yet.
But she's still
yet,
a
I'm a
teenager.
Rocker. Yeah, because mm-hmm. parang rocker siya, diba?
Mm-hmm.
But and then yet just she's a country singer, so I was a little confused, but I didn't like the dancing. There was a lot of. Suggestive movements.
Yes, gyrations.
Yeah, gyrating, and you know the Michael Jackson, like holding in the crotch and mm-hmm. And pulling your crotch up. I don't think I'd be happy seeing little girls do that.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So I hope if the parents were there, they would let their children know whom to follow.
Yeah.
And how to dress.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I know my friend Margot Salcedo goes to me, "Oy, closet conservative ka pala." I go, "No naman. You know, I don't have children, but if I was a mother and I brought my child, I would make sure that I'd explain to my kid that, you know, that
maybe this is just for a show."
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But not really to wear every day.
Yes. But speaking of singing, our guest for tonight is nothing like that. In fact, probably the complete opposite.
Well, yeah, that's what we see.
Yeah.
You know, that's what we know.
Yes.
Yes.
In fact, Jackie says that he's one of the nicest, most kind-hearted and
decent
mm-hmm. Singers in the industry, yes. In the business, yeah.
Singers, yeah, and celebrities.
Slash celebrities.
Yeah. And she said that he has a perfect combination because he's a singer and also a doctor.
Di ba ang galing?
Ang galing.
Di ba? Doctor.
Imagine mag-ooperate ka tapos kakanta ka. Magaling ba yun?
No, but you know how like every family wants a doctor, right?
Yes.
And then not only that, you have a singer. I mean, what are the chances that God gave you so much
talent? I know,
talent.
Right? And he's really nice and good looking.
I know.
Di ba?
So they're probably wondering who our guest is. They're going to have to wait a little.
Yes, we'll tell you later on when she said return. She said, and tonight, I don't know. We were asking our guest if he heard what we were saying about him, right?
Right.
So maybe we should say a little more. So I was saying that he's one of the most decent and humble and nicest persons in show business.
Right. And he, you know what? He looks it.
He is,
yeah. Yeah, he has an aura.
I know. And we were talking about some other people and he just kept quiet about them. I mean, he could actually say something about them, whatever he felt.
Yeah, we were being girls and he was being a really decent guy.
Yes, he was being a gentleman.
And gentleman, yeah.
Tumatahimik lang. Eh, nilalabas na nga natin, di ba?
He comes from a family of singers, although he was the one who started out in the business. Right?
Oh, yeah.
And then his siblings followed suit. Mm-hmm.
I wonder how that would be like living in a family that you're all performers.
I think that would be nice, diba? Like when you have to perform.
Yeah, fun.
Hirap naman when some people think they can sing and then they really can't sing and then you have to smile and then you're like, will I clap? Well, that will encourage him.
So, ladies and gentlemen, it is really our pleasure to have with us tonight Mr. Nonoy Zuñiga.
Hi, hello.
Hello.
It's my pleasure to be here.
Hi, hello.
It's my first time to be here, no?
Yeah, it's your first time.
Yes, first time. Yes. And you've been on the air for a long time na pala.
No naman, not so long.
Not so long.
Mga ano lang.
How come you only invited me now?
Because nakakahiya eh. Diba? No, actually, I saw him in the airport. Diba? Diba?
I get my guest there.
She invites because I didn't have your number and the friend who supposedly had your number is not answering back. So I saw you in the airport and said, oh, this is my chance. Thank you, Lord. So
your friend that that stays out late at night.
Yeah, yeah. He never texted back.
And
so,
sleeps a lot. Oh, okay.
So I never got your number and then I finally saw you in the airport.
Okay.
See. And nakakaya, and I was thinking, my gosh, you think he'll say yes? Do you think this? Do you think never mind, I'll just invite.
No, he's so nice, he won't think anything.
I know he's so nice. Yeah. Eh. Ang dami-dami Jackie, pakantahin mo naman. Jackie, good yan. Oh.
Speaking of kantahin, look, he was handing us something now.
Yes. Let's wait naman.
I know, I'm asking for it. No. Oh,
now na.
Okay, here's something for you, cutie.
Thank you.
And for you, Jackie.
Thank
Beginnings.
You.
This is my latest CD.
Nonoy Zuñiga, Beginnings. Mm. And who was the one who produced this?
A friend and myself.
Ah, okay. Mm.
What's You'll Never Have Find you Another Love Like Mine?
You'll Never Find.
You can dance
love
to that.
Like mine.
And you have 11 songs here.
Yes.
So these are what kind of songs?
These are the songs that I grew up with.
Right.
Because sometimes I've been asked, where did I get my style? Mm-hmm. And I always say, marami from different artists. Mm-hmm. So these are some of the artists that somehow influenced my style.
I see, okay.
Swerte lang.
Pwede bang kantahin mo a part of
why
each?
Not?
Diba?
Oh, wow. Sige. How demanding
swerte,
we are.
Swerte lang. This is a song. Was this one of the finalists sa music festival.
Oh, okay. I remember that song.
First music pop festival. Sadyabang swerte, swerte lang pag umuulan.
Oh, I remember that.
Palang ako na naabutan ng swerteng ganon.
Hawak ko ikaw.
Alam mo? Singer pala si kahit ulan ay tumilang bigla, may nangyari ng hiwaga.
You! Yeah. In person right beside
I
us.
I know.
Tapos Night and Day.
Night and Day. Mm-hmm.
Ang tagal na nito, 1940s pa ito yung song na to.
Sige, hindi pa
Night
natin.
And Day, you are the one.
Okay.
Only you beneath the moon and under the sun. Very romantic song.
Ah.
I like the classics.
Yes,
forever.
Yes.
I think they're timeless. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Father and son.
It's not time to make a change. Just relax. Take it easy. Okay. You're still young. That's your fault. It's a Cat Stevens song.
Right. And stop, then, look, and listen. Duet with?
With a friend of mine, si Cecil. Ito by the Stylistics.
Mm-hmm.
You're alone all the time. Does it ever puzzle you? Or you asked why you seem to fall in love and out again? Do you ever really loved or just pretend?
I like that song.
I love that song. I love
it's like
that song.
I want to hug somebody and dance.
Listen to your heart, hear what it's saying. Stop.
Would you stop?
That song.
Okay.
Would you look at me? Trouble with a Low is Goodbye.
Maka ano na to, luma lahat. Maganda.
You can
relate. The trouble with a Low is Goodbye. Mm-hmm. 70s to eh. And then you'll never find
the one you sang.
You're gonna miss my loving.
Ah, dance.
Lou Rawls to, Lou Rawls. And then the look of love is in your eyes. It's also
how come,
a very romantic song.
When he sings, parang nasa studio, no?
I know.
Parang meron mga ano.
Yeah, magandang sound dito. Oh. Kaya
ganun. Maganda ba?
Hindi, maganda.
Oh, maganda kami, hindi maganda yung sound. So, yun lang yata. I don't want to lose your smile.
I don't want to lose you. And another song, Smile.
Smile, we have each other.
So parang medley siya.
What's I don't want to lose
so
you?
What is?
I don't want to lose you. I love you as you are. I don't want to lose you. I couldn't love you more. Tell me, love will remain though we may change. Then smile. Smile, we have each other. Sometimes I don't know where you go. Cause love has made us one. Come on, smile.
Oh, I love those songs.
We have, yeah.
Finish na? Wala na ba?
You can close your eyes.
What's okay.
By
close
James
your eyes.
Taylor. You can close your eyes. It's all right. It's, ano to, acoustic. Acoustic, ginawa namin acoustic. It's a solo guitar. I play the guitar myself.
I think
myself.
That's the only one I'm not familiar with.
You know me also. I know all the songs.
I know all except the 11.
Except
yeah, this is not really popular, but I really love this song. And this is the song that James Taylor always sings as his last number.
Oh, not Smiling Face?
In his shows, no.
Never asked you.
Somewhere in the middle, he sings that song.
Okay, so how did you choose those songs?
Wait, hold on. Oh, yeah. All the way. Two more.
Yeah. Sorry.
When somebody loves you, it's no good unless he loves you all the way. Yeah.
Love
and
that.
And then the harder I try, the bluer I get. Lord knows that I haven't gotten over losing you.
Pwede na kami back up. Back lang kayo.
Back talaga. So far back.
At least kumakanta kayo, di ba?
Di ba? Thank you.
I love the selections. Jackie was just asking you a while ago how you chose these songs.
We listed down a number of songs. We reached about almost 50 songs. Mm-hmm. So we had to cut it down. Kasi ano eh.
How many chose? Only the two of you?
Which one?
Like how many chose the 11 out of the 50?
Ah, marami kami.
This is gonna be playing in my car when I leave here. I don't know about you.
Yeah, of course. And then put it in the iPod and everywhere.
Baka lang antukin ka kasi.
No, you know, we actually love these songs. I love these songs.
I like them.
I love the classics. I think, you know, I'm like an old soul. I like Broadway and I love the classics. Mm-hmm. I mean, like the new songs, you can't even like sing to it. Do you like the songs now?
I like to dance to the songs now, but it's difficult to sing to the songs now. But I like these songs. And you can also dance
they're
to the
singable.
Others.
That's why you can sing along with the song.
Yeah.
So one of them, you just play the guitar, the James Taylor song.
Mm,
so you also play the guitar aside from singing. Do you play the piano as well?
No, only the guitar.
Oh, but they say it's like chords. Like if you can play the guitar, if you really want to, then it will be easier to shift to piano as opposed to someone who has no background.
Oh, yes. Of course, yes. You know the chords. Eh.
So how did you start? Were you singing when you came out of your mom's tummy?
My melody na.
Who's the singer in the family? Why are you all singers?
My dad.
Ah.
My dad. And then my mom.
What kind of singer were your parents?
Well, my dad is more of the classical. Mm-hmm. Well, both of them, actually. My mom loves to hear my dad sing.
Oh, how nice.
Ganun lang. Kasi nung ano, nung sense of history to me. Kasi nung World War II, my dad was a guerrilla fighter.
Uh-huh.
And then he used to, there was this radio program, the only radio programs that time, and he sings there. Kaya lang may sinisingit siyang mga ano, kung saan, yung si Spy.
Yung may mga... Padaplis. In codes,
kung
right.
Kung saan nakatago yung mga hapon, gano'n.
Ah, galing! Oh. That's
ngayon
pretty
na
creative.
Ngayon
pwede na sabihin.
We should have your dad on the show.
I know.
He passed away already.
Oh, no.
Sorry.
Oh, okay.
If we were alive, now he's about 96.
Wow.
Sobrang tanda na.
Oh, okay. Mm.
So DJ siya, and then... And then may mga, galing ah.
How does he get away with it? He would say it in Tagalog? Or he would,
Tagalog.
Yeah? He would like pretend to be talking about the song, then padaplis, daplis.
Tagalog talaga. But galing niya.
Pero maintindihan ng mga taong dapat makakaintindi.
And minsan in Bicol pa, because it's a Bicolano. Uh-huh. Minsan in Bicol pa, so dialect talaga. Hindi na maintindihan. Ita-translate na lang, so.
That's huge. Imagine your dad played a part.
Galing ah.
See, that's when you're putting your singing talent... Or your DJing talent to good use.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Was he singing then or he was a DJ?
A singer.
He was a singer.
Oh. He sings it and then sinasabi niya yung kung saan yung
ganun?
Location ng mga kalaban.
So in between, in the middle of the song?
Mm.
So through the war, they still had entertainment. That's really good to know. the art still lived.
Yeah. What year was that? Around what year?
42.
Ah, okay.
And then he went to Samar where he... met my mom.
Right.
Yeah.
I know the war because my dad was a war baby.
Oh, see.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Your dad probably too.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. We'll have more of Nonoy Zuñiga when we come back. Don't you go away. So she said kasama po natin yung napakagwapong Nonoy Zuñiga. How do they say your name in other countries when you perform?
Zuñiga. In the US, if it's an American, it's pronounced as Nonoy.
Nonoy.
Nonoy Zuñiga.
Zuñiga.
Zuñiga or something.
Zuñiga. Why Nonoy?
They can't say O and O.
Okay, and in other countries?
Who took your photo? Who did the pictorial?
Pinatay ko na.
Why? Maganda nga eh.
Okay nga eh.
Galing. Who took
sobra
the photos?
Sa Photoshop yan ah.
Hindi. Talaga. Who took this? Papakuha rin kami.
No, you look exactly like this.
Sabay ka
na. Diba?
No. So.
Post ka nga ng ganito. Okay, actually, when we were, during the break, Nonoy was
supposed to sing another favorite song of mine.
Yeah, a favorite song of yours. Hindi mo nalagay dito.
Hindi ko nalagay.
Pero ano pa yung dapat naging 12th song dito sa album?
No, it's an OPM also.
Mm-hmm.
It's, it sounds like this.
Is it funny? What?
Be my lady.
Why?
Come to me and take my hand and be my lady.
But the
arte, may ginagaya lang ako.
He's following the mouth.
Parang may naalala lang ako.
It's not only your favorite song, but it's also her favorite song
too. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Favorite singer.
A lot of the Filipinos.
A lot naman.
Yeah. But my question is, what's the Martin. One song that they connect you to?
Never Say Goodbye.
Yes,
can you?
Why is it not here?
I love that.
Iba yun, iba. It's owned by another recording company.
I like to sing that in the karaoke. I like to sing
Never Say Goodbye. No matter how they try to show me love won't last if we're prisoners caught in our past. I'll never say goodbye. Yeah.
We know that.
Oh, the tears. So the tears running dry. Bakit? Siyempre, karaoke. No, but really, in his microphone, it really sounds
different.
It's different. It's
give him your mic. Let's see.
No, I know. It's really his voice.
It's really his voice.
Okay, so how did you join any contest in the past? Like when you were
I
in
did.
School or?
Only one contest and I
And you taught,
and I lost.
Of course. Oh, really?
No,
so
I
how did you get started in the business?
I joined contests and then... Well, a friend of mine, a folk singer, asked me to audition. Mm-hmm. He told me, if you really love to sing and you want to earn from it, why don't you rehearse and practice and collect songs? Once you reach at least 50 songs, then call me.
Oh, and then? And you
then
did it?
Then I rehearsed.
So guitar.
I rehearsed up to 70 songs.
So you did a demo.
By guitar lang. With
wow.
a guitar lang. And then, yun, I auditioned.
Napasa what kind
ko.
Of audition?
We should have made you bring your guitar.
So you just played the guitar and then you sang.
Mm-hmm. Yung panahon...
Dito sa
panahon
Pilipinas.
Namin, folk singing ang tawag doon. Mm-hmm. Ngayon, it's acoustic.
Acoustic. Okay, right. What did you sing at that time when you auditioned?
James Taylor, Cat Stevens, Don McLean. Starry, starry night, uh-huh. paint your palette blue and gray. Oh. Look out on the summer
day. So is that how you make girls fall in love with you?
No,
you
not sing? Really. I don't sing to the girls.
Oh my gosh, what's wrong with you singers? Don't you know?
when they become yours, that's when you sing to
yes.
them.
Yes.
Ah. But so who gave you your first break then? Was it that friend of yours?
As a folk singer, yes.
Yeah.
And do you then, remember but, where?
And then I joined the band, the Family Birth.
Okay.
For 5 years, every night we sing in hotels. In
Family Birth Control of Bellocilio?
Yeah, Family Birth Control Band, yes.
Ah. Who else was in there aside from you?
Who? Oh, Toots Almazan, Gigi Sanchez.
Gigi, the one who sings A Boy and a Girl?
Yes.
What's A Boy and a Girl?
He can sing reasons and he can sing like
falsetto,
a girl.
Falsetto.
I thought there's a certain song called A Boy and a Girl.
Gigi's a boy.
And wow. a girl but at the he same can, time. And,
okay. So and he can
girl
sing,
or girl
he
boy?
Can sing a girl, boy and a girl.
Okay,
so he can
fine.
Sing a girl's part. I remember.
Yeah.
So it was from the band. So we had like regular followers. And then from there you got like concert offers. And
yeah,
is that how it was?
But as a recording artist, I was discovered in another way.
Were you discovered?
I guested the fourth Metro Pop. I guest lang.
And you sang?
And I sang this song for the handicap.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Ako'y Ikaw Rin. And then after that event, right after that, Willy Cruz was there. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
And then he offered my recording contract.
Right.
Talaga?
Willy
Cruz.
Sabi ko, huh? I don't want to sing anymore. Because this was after the accident. Eh?
Mm-hmm. What accident?
A bombing accident that I lost my leg.
Oh, can
okay,
you tell
wait,
us about
wait,
that?
Yeah, yeah. So...
We want to know the story also about that.
Dami nangyari.
Okay, so
it's
after,
most interesting.
Okay, let's talk about. So you were offered a recording
by Willy Cruz
contract.
But I hesitated first because I didn't want to go into singing anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Ganon. But
yung pala,
siyempre,
yun ang
no, yung pala, no?
Mas naging ma-appeal ka. Diba?
Okay.
Blessing. It's a blessing in disguise.
Okay, so can you tell us about that also?
That day?
Yeah,
I mean, yeah, it was
where,
1980.
Where were you?
October 4, 1980. I was with a band. We were performing at the Philippine Plaza Hotel. If you remember the time when there were bombings all around Metro Manila, the real mm-hmm. bombs, they plant bombs in
what
Rustan's.
What year?
Government 80? Owned, ano ah.
Okay.
Corporations. And Rustan's. Basta kampi ka ng government, talagyan ka ng bomba, gano? Lahat, PLDT, hotels. And then...
I don't remember that. Do you?
No, I thought it was...
How old were you in 1980?
I thought it was Plaza...
Basta.
Fine, thank you. I thought it was Plaza Miranda or something.
Maybe you were in grade school that time. So.
No, but you know what? I really don't remember. Okay.
1980 yun na, 1980.
Yeah. So they planted one of the bombs in the Philippine Hotel.
Yeah, it's in Philippine Plaza. They placed it in the CR, where the dispenser, a tissue dispenser, made of steel. So that's where... Then the CR, that's where we changed into our costumes for that night.
So before going on stage.
Mm.
And
so
then?
I was just a meter away from that dispenser.
No way.
Where
were
the
you
other
closest?
Singers?
Yeah?
Oh, we andun kami halos lahat. And then ako lang naiwan, saka yung lead guitarist namin. Yun. Tapos sumabog.
Was there any clue that it was going to happen? Was there anything strange that day that...
Yun?
Yeah? Was there any like...
The usual, they give out warnings... The hotel, may warning dito na may bomb threat. No. But mm-hmm. everywhere, there are bomb threats. So, hindi naman natutuloy. So,
mm-hmm.
consider nila na hoax that
yes,
night. Pero
yes.
meron na pala.
But take us there. Mm. So, you're there. You're a meter away from the... Mm-hmm. the
you were changing.
Trashing.
No more na. Buti nga, buhis na.
Buhos na. Kasi ba, baka naman.
Nakabihis na.
Oo nga. Baka urinating pa.
So, you were like on your way out already? No.
No, not yet. I was combing my hair.
Okay,
the
and then?
Yeah, no.
Oh, and then? Oh my gosh. Yeah. So did you feel it? Or you didn't do anything?
I was numb.
Numb.
Okay, yes. Okay. And then?
What's the feeling? Numb. And then? Are you and conscious?
No feeling. No feeling.
Inside full of smoke. It was smelling like gunpowder and... Ganun talaga.
Did you know it was a bomb?
We were about 5 in that CR. 3 were guests.
Oh, no.
Mm.
Okay, I mean, not that so, it's worse for
But
yeah,
I was
okay,
nearest the bomb, so I was hit the most.
So what did you feel? Just a loud blast and then darkness,
and then,
smoke?
When I was back in my senses, I was...
You were lying
floor.
Down.
Yeah,
okay.
Did you get unconscious for a bit? I mean, considering you were so close to it?
No, I was conscious.
Conscious
all
the
time.
Whole time. Yeah.
Okay, so then, you were lying down.
Yeah, and then I tried to stand up, I fell.
Oh no.
Twice. Sabi ko, but I tried to stand up again, I fell. Then mm-hmm. I saw my leg severed. No pala. My other leg was far.
No way.
Yeah.
So as in to totally?
Yeah, totally.
Not even hanging?
Just one piece of muscle.
Oh my god.
Gross, it was gross.
Okay. So and then what did you do? Did you get your leg?
Yeah, yes.
Okay.
Automatic pala yun,
yeah,
no?
Yeah.
Pag sayo yun, you get
yeah,
your,
you
the
get
limb,
it.
Then you try to put it back there.
Oh, okay. Wait. We'll leave it at that and then we'll continue. But that's really true because I know someone, his eye was stabbed
and then he was trying to put it back
while he was on his way to the hospital.
Oh,
so okay, with that thought in mind.
I want all the details. Okay. When we return here on She said. We're back on She said, and we are going to continue to talk about something that I've always wanted to ask. About the bombing of a star. But anyway, of course, in the 80s, we were so alive, okay? We were alive, but I don't understand why we don't remember, because maybe it wasn't in the news on television.
Yes.
And it wasn't in the newspapers.
Everything from the press.
That was 1980,
there was no freedom,
so.
Remember?
Yes.
Okay, we were students, but we couldn't listen because everything was okay.
Everything was controlled. Everything we hear and see and read, remember? Mm-hmm. Your uncle fought for that.
Yeah.
That's exactly why. Because
yes,
everything was controlled. But if we didn't even think, because Jackie and I were like, why don't we know?
Why don't we remember?
Yeah.
Okay, the story that I know was it happened in Plaza Miranda. It was supposedly martial law or something? Oh, what
why
is
are
that?
You laughing?
Because Plaza Miranda is another bombing. Was another bombing accident. Incident.
Okay.
Doon na bomb sila Senator Salonga.
Yeah, the senators.
The older ones.
So you weren't a senator at that time?
No, okay, I was not a senator.
No. So, okay. So,
wait.
But that story was also what coined for you. Like, you were supposedly bombed in Plaza Miranda, right? That's what people say.
Some people say that, no.
Oh,
but
see,
others,
no,
they
some
know,
people told me.
It was kasi Philippine Plaza. Yun, because of the plaza,
right.
Siguro. Philippine Plaza.
Plaza Miranda.
You know what? Hindi rin nila alam kung saan yung... Because maybe it was not really written
yeah.
about. No?
I see.
It was not written about.
Okay.
It's not in the news.
I want to continue the story. So, you were holding your leg.
No, wait.
What?
As a doctor,
were
what's
you a
your
doctor
first?
Already?
No,
yeah.
Not yet.
I wasn't
yet.
A doctor yet.
Okay.
I was a
student.
Later na yung life ng doctor.
No, akala ko he was a doctor already.
Pala.
So, what's the first thing you'll do to save your leg? Since if being a doctor, di ba, a lot of people, they're... But you're
really?
Not a doctor pa pala.
No, but I don't... I think anybody, whether a doctor or not, would just get your leg. That's my leg, di ba?
Tama,
oh my
tama.
Baka kunin pa ng katabi mo. Oh.
So, okay.
Maganda
so,
yung shoes mo.
So, no. You...